In 2009, Richmond were tipped to be a team on the rise under Terry Wallace. However, things didn't go the Tigers' way. They finished second last on the ladder, with Wallace stepping down halfway through the season. In 2010, Damien Harwick took over a young, immature Richmond side who had no expectations to do well anytime soon. It took Harwick a complete 7-year rebuild to get Richmond from rags to riches, breaking their 37-year premiership drought in 2017, before adding two more flags in 2019 and 2020. Damien Harwick took Richmond from the bottom to the top and will be remembered for coaching one of the best sides in the AFL's modern era. In today's video, we will take a look back at Damien's first starting 22 to see the list progression from then until now. His first game was a Thursday night in 2010, where a young Richmond side lost to Carlton by 56 points to begin the Harwick reign. So a player to play in the first game under Damien Harwick was Daniel Connors. He had a career filled with behavioural issues, getting drunk quite a lot, missing training. He got delisted in 2012. He ended up in the VFL, where he was actually lead goal scorer, but Harwick gave him the flick. Nice.
Next up is Ty Vickery, a former top 8 draft pick from the 2008 draft, played 119 games for 158 goals, will be remembered mostly for sucker punching Dean Cox at Patterson Stadium, at least by me and many angry Eagles fans. Absolute flog of a bloke, but in all seriousness, he did play as a best 22 player for most of Richmond's shit phase, and then as soon as they got good, squeezed him out of the team, went to Hawthorn. He had one season, then retired because he fell out of love with the game. And frankly, we don't miss you.
Will Thursfield was also in the first starting 22 for Damien Harwick. He was a fullback. He played 24 games under Dimmer, and he retired at the age of 25. Whether it was because he was shit or he genuinely had passions outside of the game, I'm not sure. But, you know, good fullback for the 2 seasons that he lasted when Richmond was shite.
Nice. Next up, we got Richard Chamberlain, the player that Richmond famously chose over Buddy Franklin in the 2004 draft, aka Bling, as I've just learned reading the notes that you've given me. I did not know that about him. But obviously, he was expected to make a big impact at Tigerland. Was a risky draft pick, but was expected to have a great career. Didn't end up being the player that Richmond wanted him to be. He was traded to the Crows for a first and a third round draft pick, which ended up being a very good deal for Richmond in hindsight, because Tambling didn't do much at Adelaide either. Where is he now, you ask? Well, he played 16 games in 3 years for the Adelaide Crows and then got delisted in 2013.
Many a stinky player in this side, and that's what makes the reign of Damien Harwick so impressive, because there are so many stinky players in this team. Another one was Adam Thompson. Played 2 games under Harwick. He got delisted and he was last seen in Daniel Bush's basement.
Next up, we have the infamous Relton Roberts, a man who wore number 50 on his back for the Tigers, which is handy because he was a larger man. You need a larger back to fit on both those quite wide numbers.
That's facts.
He wasn't an overly successful player. He did get dropped to the reserves. And in fact, he got in trouble once for breaking curfew and eating a hamburger the night before the game.
Some call him the Hamburglar.
He then bounced around a couple of state leagues around the country. He played for the Northern Territory Footy League, the New South Wales League, and in Victoria, of course, as well. And I believe he was last seen at a Hungry Jack's.
Troy Simmons, a former Docker, was another player who played in Dimmer's first game. He played 93 games for Richmond, but only 7 under Damien Harwick. He's a brand development director. That's where he is. Nice to know.
Good on you, Troy. Next up, we have the current skipper, Trent Cotchin. He's a 3-time premiership player under Harwick, so he's been an illustrious player. He's played almost his entire career of 243 games under Harwick, other than maybe 2 seasons. And I know that Harwick values him as one of the most influential players over Richmond's rebuild under him as coach. So, yeah, slam dunk that one.
Started from the bottom. Now he's a 3-time premiership player.
Yeah, yes.
Nice. Another successful player to come out of this terrible Richmond side in 2010 was Jack Revolt, who kicked 2 goals in Damien Hardwick's first game against Carlton. 3-time Coleman medalist, 3-time premiership player, an all-time great at Tigerland. 237 games under Harwick, and yeah, he'll go down as one of Richmond's best ever forwards.
Next up, we have to mention the captain of Richmond at the time, and he was the captain of this footy club between 2009 and 2012. I'm talking about defender Chris Newman. He played 114 games of his career under Harwick, and then he ended up playing 268 overall. Obviously, kind of missed that successful period with Richmond. He's now retired, of course. And he ended up coaching Box Hill, which is Hawthorn's affiliate club, and he was VFL Coach of the Year in 2017. And in 2018, he actually led that club to a premiership in the VFL, which is a pretty handy coaching career already. And he's now an assistant coach at the Hawthorn Footy Club.
A brief career at Richmond did this player have? It's Ben Nason, the long-haired, dreadlocked blonde. He played 2 seasons at Richmond before being delisted. 23 games in those 2 seasons, became a cult figure quite quickly, just due to his whack haircut, really. He's been off the grid and last seen working at Caltech's.
Next up, we have the little Lebanese maestro, Robin Nahas, who played 64 games for the Richmond Footy Club before being delisted and picked up for North by North for a further 34 games. He was delisted in 2016 and ended up playing some VFL as well for Port Melbourne. He ended up being the playing forward line coach in a premiership team in 2017 before retiring from the VFL in 2018. He is now a player coach for North Ringwood in Victoria, which I think we can all agree is a hilarious name.
Ringwood.
North. Ah, come on.
No. Mitch Morton was another player in Dimmer's first starting 22. He played 21 games under Damien Harwick. He was traded at the end of 2011 to Sydney for the 79th pick and actually went on to have a very successful career playing in that grand final side in 2012, kicking two goals against Hawthorn in that grand final. Ended well for him. He retired and pursued a corporate career. So, you know, from grand finals to bloody tax or something. Boring.
Next up, we have the illustrious Kelvin Moore, who played 87 games at AFL level, but played only 22 of them under Damien Harwick, so didn't really last long into this era. Where is he now? Well, he was last seen in 2015 drinking an entire bottle of Tabasco sauce on the middle of a Melbourne nightclub dance floor.
Oh, that's fucked. Luke McGuan was another player in this side. He played 51 games under Damien Harwick. He got delisted by Richmond in 2013. When they cleared out some stink. He went to Brisbane, played only 7 games before retiring due to injury. He now plays at Port Melbourne with Jake King, apparently.
Next up, we have the infamous Dusty Martin. I don't really need to tell you exactly where he is these days. Probably losing it with Fisher.
Nice.
Obviously, one of the champions of the modern game at the moment. He ran those 3 Norm Smiths and had basically his entire career under Hardwick, if I'm not mistaken. And he's going to go down as one of the best all-time AFL players, certainly in big games. Now, Hardwick has said publicly that Cochin's one of the most influential players to his sort of reign as coach, but Dusty Martin is probably by far the most talented, I would say. So, yeah, Dusty's doing all right.
Daniel Jackson, he was another player that played in that really stinky Richmond side that was losing every week, basically. Bit of a grinder. Played 87 games under Damien Hardwick. He was a one-club player, so, you know, a bit of loyalty about him, but he retired in 2014. Injuries caught up to him. He's now at Adelaide as a leadership coach.
Next, we have to acknowledge Tom Hislop, who played 8 games under Damien Hardwick. And as a fun fact, he was actually drafted twice in the national draft by both Essendon and Richmond, and then drafted again in the 2011 rookie draft.
Drafted 3 times. He must be pretty good.
Draft city, bitch. Draft city. I had nothing.
Played 8 games under Hardwick, so, you know, irrelevant.
Yeah.
Again, another forgotten player, Mitch Farmer, played under Damien Hardwick for 2 seasons, delisted at the end of 2011, and I could not find anything about this bloke. Who is he? He's gone. It doesn't matter. Next.
Same with me and Shane Edwards, frankly, to be honest. 265 games of what? No, but in all seriousness, Shane Edwards has probably been, like, routinely one of the most underrated players in the AFL for ages. Now he's won multiple All-Australians, I think, if I'm not mistaken. He's won one, sorry. Yeah, fuck that up. He's played 218 games out of 265 under Hardwick, and he's played in all 3 premierships as well. And he's the sort of player who the stats don't really show how much impact he's had, so he's still a really good player for Richmond. Towards probably the twilight of his career, but obviously still in the side. So that's where he is now.
Always be remembered in those premiership sides. Coming down to the pointy end of the video, we've got 2 superstars of the game. Brett Deledio, the best player in a shite Richmond team for all those years, left to go to GWS to chase a flag. Did he get it?
No. Unfortunately not.
Lost in a prelim to Richmond, and then Richmond went on to win the flag that year. So, you know, come back to bite him on the arse leaving Richmond. I don't know if it was up to him or not.
Yeah, the Deledio thing was a bit of a heartbreak. Obviously, he went to chase a premiership at a club that seemed more successful than Richmond, and then to lose to Richmond in the prelim, like, maybe some fans felt happy and, like, satisfied about that, but I was watching it going, oh, the poor bloke, that would be the worst feeling.
And now he's a player agent, so maybe he can, you know, learn from his bad decisions that he made. Who's the last player who played in that 22 against Carlton when they lost by 56 points in 2010?
Jeez, that was some good lung capacity from you. It was, of course, one of my all-time favourite players, Benny Cousins from the West Coast Eagles, obviously famously ended up at Richmond for a couple of years under Damien Hardwick as well. Where is he now, you ask? Well, you'll be very satisfied to hear. He actually runs a very successful computer science program. I don't even know what that is.
Just got released from prison for stalking his ex. He's been to prison many a times. Imagine Dusty Cochin, Ben Cousins, and Brett Deledio in a midfield in their primes. That's stacked. But obviously, Dusty was young, Koch was young.
Deledio was sort of established, but yeah, Ben Cousins was a coke bender or three past it. So that's going to wrap up this video. If you enjoyed this video, drop a like, drop a sub, bit different. Thanks, Jesse, for coming on. Always plenty of content coming when me and Jesse are about. Thank you for watching. Have a good day, you plonkers.